So the talk will be more like a short introduction of the situation that we have now, a bit of review from the Russian underground, what's going on, and then it will be questions for all of you, where do we go? So a lot of services in banking and everywhere depends on the second factor authentication based on SMS or phone calls, and we can look wherever. Mail services like Gmail, registration on the social media platforms like Instagram, Facebook, and many other things. So everybody, you need to receive SMS. And another topic is SMS banking. So sometimes you're receiving SMS to confirm your banking transactions, but in countries like in Africa or in Russia, you can fully manage your banking accounts just sending SMS. So just to transfer money, you can just send SMS with amount of money and every banking account or phone number. So as a and where in our services where like phones use it to manage banking accounts, it's USSD. So here is example from I think Indian Citibank, and here is another example, and we can get way more examples. Actually you can consider SIM cards, like prepaid SIM cards, like debit cards, and postpaid or contracts like credit cards. So, and what's one of the messages we have? So what's going on? So in the terms of underground, like Russia usually is the victim of cyber attacks which happened later in United States and Europe. So what we're having in Russia, customers of the banks receiving a call from a legitimate bank number. Like, for example, Sberbank have number 900. And customers getting calls from tech support from legitimate banking numbers, and we are criminals because we are able to substitute a bank phone number. So be prepared here. Or there are signs that SS7 attacks has been used against banking customers. So it's another level where it is possible to make attacks at the scale. So what's going on the underground? Just some insights, maybe with prices. So it's lending of SMS. Like it's possible to receive SMS, and the price is like $6 in this case. Maybe you can't read the services names, but you can recognize the icons. So the price to lend SMS for registering account in different services, so 3 rubles, it's roughly 5 American cents. And these kind of things use it to make bot campaigns, to make fraud at scale, and for many other activities. And the price are quite reasonable. I don't know why VK costs 10, Russian social network, which is like Facebook in Russia, costs like 35 cents instead of 3 cents. But everything else is around between 3 and 5 cents. This is another topic, like intercepting a phone calls. So this is request, and this is Hector trying to understand the market in Australia. So he can do this, and he just asking if anybody interested. So the same request is in UK, and the same request you can get for SMS interception. What does it mean with second factor authentication? Using SMS and mobile phone calls are really, really questionable already. And underground is ready, for this. And we're exploiting this not at the big scale now, but you can find the services which fulfill all the requirements. So this is this advertisement match, the banking fraud that happened in Russia this summer. And this is a SIM recovery, like polite term, it's SIM recovery, but actually it's a hijacking of the SIM card linked to the banking accounts. And what means, as long as SIM was recovered, it is possible to recover access for online banking and just manipulate all the money at a particular banking account. So my question is for you. So I have two answers. So first of all, if we just abstract from SMS and phone calls, some mobile operators know about you way more than banks, so they don't need to send you anything. And when you're just wearing your phone in your pocket, that's enough to authenticate you. And like for banks, the situation is more complicated. So my question for you, like any ideas when this kind of authentication will die? Raise your hands.
Is that a real hand raising? We don't do this on lightning talks.
Firstly, it's not 2 FA, it's 1.5 FA. I would not consider it to be 2 FA, sorry. Secondly, it will not die because it's good advertisement money for the companies like Facebook and so forth. Because I would say that phone number is one of the primary keys that they connect to you.
It's like handle.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, that's it. No more questions. No, go on then. One more.
I think not all operators are prone to SSS7 attacks. Not all of them. Many, but not all.
No.
Maybe they just...
Yeah, no more. This is lightning talks. We don't have time.
Okay. Come on, off just you go. One more.
Off you go.
Just one more. Please.
Which one?
You had a question.
Who?
You had. Everybody saw this.
It's not a question, it's more of an answer. As he said, it will never die, but maybe it will, I don't know.
Okay, that's it, come on, let's go.
What about females?